Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.
Arr, ahoy, crew members. Today's show is a service of our Amazon page. Please remember to shop Amazon, and when you do, go to MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon or click the Amazon link on our website. It's the best way to shop and the best way to support this show. Thank you.
Available on demand every day in iTunes and the Google Play Store and around the world on MikeO'MaraShow.com. What more can we do for you? It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Before we get rolling on the Mike O'Mara Show, Rob, you've got a phone call. Somebody said, the receptionist said it's your doctor on the phone.
You really? Take that? Yeah, please. Yeah. I put them right on. Hello?
Yeah, Mr. Speedwagon?
Yes.
This is Dr. McGinnifonic, and yes. I wanted to discuss how's the bronchitis going?
Oh, it's not bronchitis, doctor. As you remember, it's sinusitis.
Sinusitis. Has it gotten into your lungs yet?
It's on its way. You can bet.
I think we
nipped it in the bud. We're on our third day of antibiotics, and I'm sure we're going to be fine.
You're taking the antibiotics that I prescribed for you?
Yes, the amoxicillin.
You're taking the plaquenilmycin?
No, amoxicillin. Same that you gave to my wife for her tonsillitis. And my daughter for her mystery sore throat.
Yeah. How are your two sons doing?
I have one son that's Robert. He's healthy.
Yeah. Right,
and I have Julia, who's the daughter.
All right, have you been washing your hands on a regular basis, Mr. Speedway?
I have. Well, first
have you been using the Purell? Have you been using the Purell, Mr. Speedway?
The what?
The Purell.
No.
The disinfectant so you don't spread the germs to the rest of the family.
No, I don't use that.
Have you been eating plenty of raw fruits and vegetables?
No, I've been cooking all of my vegetables.
You've been cooking? Now, Mr. Spiewak, as we discussed, the raw fruits and vegetables are beneficial health-wise, especially during cold and flu season. That's why the fact that you are cooking to death most of those vegetables might be one of the reasons you're getting me.
And the fruits. I just can't eat a cold banana, doctor.
Mm-mm. I'd like you to come into the office later this week if it's possible. I've got some samples of botulinum that you might want to sample.
Can you send those along via the mail? I don't want to, you know.
No, Mr. Spiewak, as a matter of fact, I'd like to do, if we could do it on the phone, is there a chance that we could perhaps do a little, could you take your hand and put it on your right testicle, please?
Sure, hold on.
All right, now cough.
Hold on, that's the left one.
Okay, good. Now could you cough, please?
I can't seem to, oh, there it is. Oh, yeah, okay.
Right. All right, now please cough, Mr. All right, thank you very much. Now take your hand and put it over your left breast.
Okay.
And gently palpitate.
Hmm.
Do you feel any odd shapes or bumps or anything?
The only thing I feel right now is love.
All right, very good. Now do the same to the right. Same to the right.
Please. Right hand or left
yes,
hand?
Yes, it can be the right hand, please.
Okay, so can I do them both at the same
yes.
time?
Yes, now gently palpitate.
Yes.
Very good. Mm. All right. Are you taking any over-the-counter medications, Mr. Spiewak?
I do believe my nipples have just punctured my T-shirt.
Mr. Spiewak, please focus on the conversation.
Sorry,
are you taking any over-the-counter products at all?
Yes, I am.
Yes.
Now, vitamins?
What vitamins are you taking? So you're taking a B12?
I'm taking Centrum Silver.
Are you taking Centrum Silver? Is that true? Is that really true? You're such a consumer. Yeah. Are you Centrum Silver? That's one.
And I'm also
Is it Centrum Women's Silver
I
recommend?
I actually have the bottle here with me. It's here it is. Centrum Silver for obese women. Older
very nice.
Women.
That's good. How's your supply of suppositories? Is that still holding up well?
You know, they disappear at an alarming rate, but I just re-upped. Yeah,
that's wonderful. Now, I'd like you to take your pinky finger and put it in your right ear.
Right
second,
or left?
Right ear. Right finger, ear. Right ear. That's the way. Probably be a little difficult for you to get the left finger in the left ear.
It.
Oh, you can do that. Oh, that's great. You're very flexible. Yeah. That's great. How's that feel?
Marvelous.
That feels pretty good, doesn't it?
Yeah. Hold on a second.
In there.
There might be infection, doctor.
That's wonderful. Oh, dear. Have you been sleeping in any cat or dog beds?
Cat or dog or cat
have you
dog?
Been putting your head down in the cat or dog bed?
No, not on his bed, no.
Do you have any dogs, Mr. Speedway?
One dog.
What is the breed?
He's a mutt, a mixture of mostly beagle and flat-coated collie.
No,
yeah.
No. Beagle's bad. Very, very bad. Beagles are known carriers of viruses. That's a very bad thing.
Should we put him down?
What's the other mixture? What pot dog is it? What is it, Mr.
He's also got some collie.
All right. Very good. How's your sexual function? Is everything, the ups and downs going the way they should normally, Mr. Smeaway?
You know, without getting too graphic, there have been three ups and two downs in the course of this conversation.
Very good. That's well, then we check that off the list. I just have a couple more questions for you, Mr. Please. Smeaway, and then we'll send you on your way.
I'd like to give you. How are your sinuses, Dr. McGillis?
My sinuses are perfectly fine. Perfectly fine.
Can you give me a nice deep sniff?
I'm not the patient, Mr. Smeaway. You are. Now, I know you're a talker, but I'd really like to just finish the over-the-phone exam, if I may.
Is there a copay for this?
Yes, there is. Yeah, I'm giving you medical attention. I'm providing a service to you, Mr. Spiewak. I have to make a living as well.
Understood. Yes.
Okay. So we check the ear. We check the palpitation. No misshapes or tumors or goiters on the breast area. We check the testicles. There is no hernia. The presenting symptoms are of a sinusitis, which has already been prescribed with bedoxbexhicmicillin, and you are set with that. And other than that, how are your stools? How are your stools? Your stools okay?
They are gigantic. And
no more odor than a hot biscuit. Just like they were the last time. That's magnificent, Mr. Spiewak. You getting plenty of roughage?
Yes, I am.
How's your temperature?
Right now, 100.6.
100.6. I believe with the business meeting prior to the show, it was 103. I'm glad that's gone down a little bit. All right, I'd like you to make a home remedy for me, Mr. Spiewak. Sure. You have a pen and pencil, you can write this down, and then I can be on my way, and you can get better. You can be a healthier man.
Go ahead.
All right, I want you to take a cup of a large drinking cup, a drinking glass. Do you have a 16-ounce glass or a vessel or a cup that you can use, a plastic cup that you can mix things in?
Sure, like a Red Solo cup.
A Red Solo cup would be marvelous. Yeah, that's fine. That'll do the trick. That'll do the trick. I want you to fill it with 1/8 of a cup of oatmeal.
1/8 a cup of oatmeal, yes.
Half a cup of raisins.
Half a cup of raisins.
Then I want you to fill about half of it with water, just enough to cover the raisins in the oatmeal.
Cover the raisins in water.
All right. Then I want to put a little baking soda.
Baking soda.
Some raw tea leaves. Raw tea leaves. You can find them in any grocery store, Mrs. Spiewak. Right? There's no need to ask any further questions about this. Raw tea leaves. So you got the baking soda, the oatmeal, the raisins, the water, and the raw tea leaves.
Raw tea leaves, right.
All right, just about a finger of any good bourbon will do.
Yes.
Like a Knob Hill. Do you have that? Do you have that, Knob Hill?
You look who you're talking to.
Okay. Just put a tiny bit of that, then put it in a blender, mix it up.
Okay,
all right.
And then?
Put it in a large basting syringe that you would use for a turkey.
Yes.
And put it in your
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. You can listen to the Mike O'Mara Show at www.mikeomarashow.com.
Stay tuned for an outstanding entertainment program.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show.
Let's get down to business.
From the entertainment capital of the world.
Hey, look, here she comes. Watch how she won't even...
Hey, Beck, what's up? You look really nice. How long can a woman be mad at you for?
Well, it kind of depends on what you did.
Well, first of all, nothing on purpose. We were going out for a minute. Thought she was cool. I really liked her. But then I sort of accidentally slept with her roommate.
That doesn't help.
I didn't know she was a roommate. I met her out. Mm-hmm. How would I know that?
Hey, Nikki.
Ben, tell me. I don't know this stuff. You're older. You've been through a lot. I mean, you have a lot of experience. How long do you think she'll be mad at me for?
I assume you talked to her, apologized, told her how much she means to you.
Well, you know.
You didn't talk to her? What'd you do, send her a tweet?
No, of course not. I, texted her a billion times. She didn't answer, so then I emailed her. But it was, a nice email. It was a long one, well thought out. Subject line, I wrote, "I'm sorry," with, a ton of O's. So I was like, "I'm sorry," with the sad emoticon where he's crying the side of its little cheek. I should probably actually just talk to her, huh? Obviously.
Can't imagine it would hurt.
It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mike O'Mara, Robb Spiewak, Oscar Santana.
And now, from his office chair, here's Mike.
Coming to you live from the Cappy Fiber Studio in the heart of our nation's capital, Washington, D.C., this is the Mike O'Mara Show. On the air and online worldwide, the Mike O'Mara Show is a daily radio show and podcast with the greatest listeners on the planet because they get it. And if you are here, you do too. Hey, FanDuel people. Hey, FanDuel players. Hey, people. Got big news. We're going to talk about it in just a second here, but I want to tell you all about FanDuel Week 3 of fantasy football. Quit standing on the sidelines. You watched your friends playing, and now it's your turn to get signed up at FanDuel.com. I watched
in the Sunday Million contest, which was a $25 entry fee for $1 million. And I watched this guy who had a lineup that killed in every particular area. And they weren't necessarily the guys you would think at the top of the heap. And it was fascinating to watch as the Sunday progressed, and the first quarter he had the lead, then the second quarter, then the third quarter, then the fourth quarter. And you realize that this one guy at FanDuel.com is taking home $1 million.
It happens.
And, you know, if you talk about, playing some other fantasy league where you have to do it all season long, this guy put that lineup in this week, and he was able to walk away with $1 million at FanDuel.com.
Unreal.
The trusted leader in one-week fantasy football. More winners and more payouts than any other site. Over $75 million per week this football season. And, Robb, we will get to the standings in a second here because it's a big part of the show. Building a team is easy. Join him. This guy, let me tell you, Mike Epp from Pittsburgh turned $7 into nearly $9,000. That's the first week he played. There's money all over to be won at FanDuel.com. We all play. Robb, Oscar, Mike, go to FanDuel.com/TMOS. Click on the microphone in the upper right-hand corner. Use our code TMOS and sign up now. Here's a special offer for new users. For every dollar you deposit, FanDuel will match it up to $200 that gets earned as you play. That's a bonus of up to $200. This offer only good for the first 50 people that use the code TMOS. Just remember to enter TMOS at FANDUEL.com. FanDuel, where every day is a new season. Sign up today. And because I've become, for some strange reason, you can't push me to do these things.
No.
It happens organically.
It
I have become somewhat. It happened organically.
It did.
You got
I
have into become it. You obsessed. Went both feet.
And I will tell you, with the Redskins playing the Giants on Thursday night, my football game of the week was over. So it was just like I needed something to make it interesting because I love my Sunday football and it's fun. And, you know, I lied to Jimmy and told him I was going to try to be a Bills fan, but I didn't feel that same joy when they beat the Dolphins, maybe because I live down in South Florida. I don't know.
Unless you're lying right now.
No, it's just I'm happy for Jimmy. Hey. The teams that are long suffering, I feel great for. For example, I will be a massive Chicago Cubs fan in the postseason of Major League Baseball. But with this FanDuel thing, I was probably in not just the Mike O'Mara Show League, which filled up right away, but I was in two Sunday leagues and then a $1 million league. And I watched this guy just kick ass. And then today, because I knew I was out of the running yesterday when we did the FanDuel commercial, I came in and I see on the FanDuel winner sheet the one guy that won big, and then I see Schmosker Schmantana that is up there, and I only and now there are a lot of people
our
who
top
call
three finishers
that.
Mike our top yes. three finishers in our and by the way you can play again in week four. Just go to FanDuel.com/TMOS. We'd love to have you along. Third place, Jay Bernstein, 13. Second,
you know
place,
this guy, Robb, because you know more listeners than anybody else.
I don't
else.
Know Jay know Bernstein. I do know that the person you just referenced was named Schmosker Fantana.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
And that guy. And in first place, our winner, $125, Purple Sage, P-R-P-L-S-A-G-E. Congratulations.
Purple Sage was the big winner. Oscar, are you indeed Schmosker Fantana?
Schmosker Fantana has taken on a life of his own because he's got his own Facebook page. He's got his own Twitter handle.
Do you think it's the same guy on all these platforms?
It's got to be.
Wow.
So
and
it's
now,
not you.
No, I wish it was
it's
me.
It's not you. That's no, a I'm so disappointed.
I'm in
I thought it was you.
Place.
No, no, Oscar. Oh, actually, no. Here's how the key finishers on the show did. Mike, you were not in the bottom 50. Good for you.
I
147th, Mike O'Mara.
I suck ass.
Adrian, the intern, yo, 135th. Oscar Santana, 105th.
Yeah.
Not bad.
Robb, turn your send up to me just to scotch. Would you be a deer and do
I would
that
be a deer.
I was in the top 100 yesterday, and Aaron Rodgers, you son of a bitch.
No,
I
Aaron Rodgers is a good guy.
Now
Aaron
for you
yeah,
guys,
but you got Aaron Rodgers got 34 points.
Aaron Rodgers is why I came in 44th.
Yeah, Mike, everybody that had Aaron Rodgers went up the depth charts as I went down.
But here's what sucks. Robb Ford, 38th place.
Oh, Mike. He has been dogging you for years.
He sandbagged you, Mike, is what happened. Yeah.
Rofo. See, I thought I was going to prove to Rofo. Rofo. I thought I was going to prove to Rofo that I could do better.
How'd Rofo's mom do?
Rofo's mom was not mentioned in the highlights. I'm sorry.
She,
she didn't make the highlight reel.
Sorry, Mom. Anyway.
But you're gonna kill it in week four, aren't you?
Let me show you this lineup. You realize the guys that really kill on these leagues, this guy, his name is Cookies, and he generated 250 points.
From Cake and Cookies?
Yes, it's Katie.
No, it's just, this is a guy in another league on FanDuel. Okay. You know, one of the thousands, hundreds of thousands or whatever that are in this league.
I've come to understand this. It has not as much to do with the players as it does what the players are going up against. You have to look at the matchups
it's percentages
and the oppositions.
It's percentage of ownership, I think, the way it works. I'm so into it right now. I swear to God, it's ridiculous. So this guy starts Cam Newton. Cam Newton. Listen to this guy that won $1 million.
Okay.
Cam Newton, okay, starts him. $7,900 salary, all right? That's not one of the elite. That's
not
one of the
elite.
$9,000 Tom Brady guys. 29.9 points. Then he puts in... I thought Joseph Randall was a running back that was splitting the duties with Dallas. This guy generates 29.5 points.
Wow.
for the Cowboys against Atlanta. Then you would think, like so many dumb fantasy players, well, if you're going to put a running back for one team, you don't want to put a running back for another team.
Right,
because
you're splitting. But
you
would. It makes sense. You think that you'd be splitting your points.
He puts in Devontae Freeman of the Atlanta Falcons, who are playing the Dallas Cowboys, and Devontae Freeman generates 39.8 points.
Wow.
For this. I gotta find out what's going on. Somebody tell me what the hell is going on?
I believe they're texting each other.
What's going on? Are we having a problem?
Something's going on in style.
Please communicate. I hate it.
First of all, what is the protocol for you, Mike? And I, God bless you. This is your show.
Yes.
Do you not want me to text him? Do you not want me to write him? Do you not want me to talk to him? What do you want me to do? You were padding just fine. I would have come back and we would have continued the show.
I want you to tell me. I can't help it. I'm not a professional like that. I see you two and Pony. I see Pony and Oscar talking and arms are flailing and everything's going around. I'm just kind of curious what's going on.
It has to do with Ustream and it has nothing to do with the format or progress of this program.
Well, we had a problem with Ustream yesterday. Are we having a problem with Ustream again today?
No, we have just a quick audio issue that I'm just trying to help him out with. Right, that really affects 100 people.
That we had a problem with Ustream yesterday?
Yes,
or am I
did.
The only one that's aware of
that? I heard that as well.
All right, very good. Yes. We'll fix it. Anyway, so Devontae Freeman, this guy, 39.8 points. Just a monster day. A monster, monster day. Then you go down his lineup. DeAndre Hopkins of Houston, 20 points. Keenan Allen of San Diego, 31 points. Steve Smith. These are middle of the pack guys.
You know what?
Borderline guys. All of them.
I think that there's a lot of luck involved, and that says to me.
Oh, there is.
Anyone can win $1 million.
Steve Smith of your Baltimore Ravens generated 37 points.
Oof.
Everybody in his lineup was almost a 30-point player, except for DeAndre Hopkins.
Wow!
And Greg Olsen,
what defense
another
did
almost
he run?
30 points. He ran the Seattle defense. At this point, it was almost a foregone conclusion. He got 18 points out of his Seattle Seahawks defense too. And Steve Gostkowski of your New England Patriots, the kicker for the Pats, he got 17 points out of him.
Wow!
Everybody generated, and I was sitting there going, how must that feel, seriously? I'm not doing a commercial for FanDuel. I'm doing the just consider this a discussion of fantasy football when you're looking at that. And can you imagine what that feeling must be like when you're just sitting there and you're going,
watching the points stack up.
I am in first place and I am in my and these guys, every guy, you got several guys on here that had career days.
Yeah.
And I think it's very cool. And so boys, I was watching this on Sunday. And just being sucked in like you wouldn't believe.
Right.
I'll be there next week. I'm going to have a different strategy. I'm not going to go with all these
marquee
guys.
Are you researching? What are you doing?
What is your strategy?
I'm trying
Does the strategy have a name?
Yes, Mike Likes.
Mike Likes.
No, what I'm trying to do is I am trying to figure out the best sources for information where I will be able to start a guy that not everybody else is starting that might have a monster day. It has to do with the low
percentage picks.
Yes, yeah, and like for example, very expensive
under the radar.
Matt Forte of your Chicago Bears just quit. Just quit, Forte. Just don't. Why even bother with 7.4 points for $8,400? You useless sack of crap.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
No, you know what? Part of the strategy. Maybe Mike is trying to get inside Matt Forte's head.
Maybe he is.
Mm-hmm. Frank Gore was the only guy that performed, but he's expensive. So, well, he's not that expensive. He's only $7,000. Anyway, if we're overloading you with fantasy, it's because we never do and we never
but
talk about
fun.
It. But
it is so
I am
much
all
fun.
In. Oscar, you're getting into it too a little bit, right? You're getting into it to a certain extent.
I think the first week I was locked out of the Mike O'Mara show league. So this is what I technically just lay in a dummy lineup on Wednesdays. To get already into the actual
Oh, and then you can tweak
league,
it?
And then I tweak it. You can always change your lineup up to the 1 p.m. Game on Sunday. So I lay in a quick dummy lineup, and then I go back on Saturdays, and I say, okay, who can I use? And I'm trying to pull from the right resources here because my first foray into this type of fantasy gave me, I think, 116 points. This week, with the help of Government Cheese... Government cheese. I got 144 points, but still not in the money. But a lot of fun to talk to a real pro about fantasy. You need John Anthony, Mike, is what you need. You need a John Anthony.
What kind
who's
of advice
John,
is
who's
he
John Anthony?
John Anthony is a famous gambler and a character in a movie. So you can
all right,
I
need
way.
Somebody to. I really need my guy. I need my guy to. I will be accepting lineups from people. You can send me a message, and I'd be happy to do that. I'm one of my lineups already got Mr. Eli Manning, who's going to have a big day against the Buffalo Bills.
But you,
sorry, Jimmy, but that's what I.
You were just about. Not 2 days ago talking about how much you hate him and his entire family.
Hate him. He's capable. He is capable once in a while with that receiver core of having a big day.
Do you
I can't
remember
we are doing? What?
Chicken parm, you taste so good.
Do you remember
his brother.
Two for the Money?
What's
the
two
movie
for the
Two
money?
For the Money with Al Pacino?
Oh,
one of them.
Oh, yeah, Al Pacino's best movie.
Yeah, John Anthony was the gambler, the professional gambler. You need
John
your own
Anthony.
John Anthony. Yeah.
All right. I'm a fan of Michael Q. Anthony, the former WINX DJ.
Very good disc jockey.
The Michael Q. Anthony.
Doesn't Two for the Money sound like a movie that would have an older Harvey Korman and Tim Conway in it?
Two for the Money.
Yeah.
And all the hijinks that occur when they try
movie.
To rob a bank.
Featuring.
And an accountant and an insurance salesman get in a Volkswagen and travel to Burbank where they try. And of course, it's in Burbank because that's the cheap place to shoot.
And that's where they're nearby. Yeah. And you know who would be in it? Also, Jack Weston.
Do you know how bad I am? I'm actually looking at fantasy right now, and I'm trying to set a lineup, and I'm not.
You have
a
better shot at baseball. I don't know why you're not playing baseball.
You understand baseball. You understand
too many people.
No,
oh, by
no.
the way, since we're all talking sports now, they ended up suspending Jonathan Papelbon.
Yeah, he's out
in that altercation with Bryce Harper.
He
in the
is
dugout.
Out,
and so you know, it's
the jerseys are coming
move.
Down the stores. I mean, he's not going to be back next year. No
it's funny when they both said they were like brothers. We fight like brothers. Yeah,
not when one brother is younger and faster and smarter and hotter,
and the other brother is not going to be in the league anymore.
Yeah.
This is my unemployed brother.
This was very interesting, I thought.
Yes,
and,
I said hotter.
Kind of ballsy. There's a guy named, I think it's Mark Loretta. Let me see if I've got that right. He used to play for the Boston Red Sox. And Mark Loretta was talking about the altercation between the two. And Loretta was kind of indicating that a relief pitcher should never call out a day-to-day player because the day-to-day players just log more time there on the field. And, you know, he talks about that the relief pitchers are up in the clubhouse getting a rub down, having a sandwich, getting ready to roll down to the dugout for the sixth inning when they might be called on. And it was just interesting that I thought.
So you're saying that there are like there's different ranks. There's sort of a social order within the team that you don't get the right to yell at me because you're up there being pampered.
Yeah, I think that's just that's the way it is, you know. And he was called. I hope it was Mark Loretta. I don't see it here. So
it was Loretta Lynn. It turns out
it was not Loretta Lynn.
The first lady of country music, Mike.
Let me see.
A great lady.
Oh, God. I don't know. I don't know where it is, but...
But the fact that culture exists within a team, isn't that... I mean, and, you know, I've never played any sports outside of, you know, competitive theater. Doesn't it... Don't you want to foster more of a sense of team than the fact that you're building social classes within the organization? The whole fact that he says that is not good, right?
Well, the fact is, if you're going to... The whole reason that Papelbon got into the kitchen with Bryce Harper is because, Harper hit a pop-up, and he didn't run down the line, and Papelbon called him on it. They'd had a little bit of a tense exchange where Bryce Harper had talked about Papelbon hitting a guy and been derogatory about that. These guys don't like each other. These guys, you know. And now, some major league players are saying that Papelbon was right to attack. You know, that's so that's you know, you got some guys that are actually defending him, you know, but a lot of players are saying that wasn't the right thing to do.
Well, so, you know, just speaking in very broad terms, I would think picking a fight in the dugout with your own team is not a right move to do.
Well, it's also when they're out of the playoffs and the team sucks.
Well, there's frustration.
What everybody expected them to do.
I mean, at that game, that if I'm not mistaken, Mike, you can clear this up. The game that when that happened is it was a they shouldn't even be playing the game. It was a non-factor, right?
Non-factor.
The Mets won, like it was
eliminated.
Yeah.
Right? Eliminated. Yeah. I think they've been eliminated on Saturday. So you know, that's it. I mean, it's just it's something that. You know, one player anonymously said, I would have done the same thing if I was Papelbon. As a teammate, you always feel you have the right to say something to someone if you feel it's wrong or hurts the club. Right after the pop-up is not the best time to call out a hitter, another player said. So players are divided on this, what you're supposed to do. You know, I don't know. I think that Papelbon has a reputation of being a dick and being a bad teammate. And so I think that, you know, that's why. Yeah, and when you do it right after the guy gets an out, you're not happy about doing that. I don't know. I think you just, look, everybody's the same. If the manager can't call people out, it's supposed to be a player's manager. I don't know. It's
I can only go on what you've said in the past, and we've known each other a long time, but don't you think this speaks to bad management within the team that this would be allowed to happen at all?
Yeah, I think it speaks to that, but it also the emotional situation with the team being eliminated. It's a long slog. And,
sure.
You know, these guys, most of them, God love them, they want to win, right? And especially for people in D.C., they can relate to this. Nationals fans, long, tremendously disappointing season. And this is a town that has had disappointment after disappointment after disappointment. I mean, right now, Washington, D.C., where our show is based, you are talking about a city that is absolutely clamoring
yep.
for anything, you know, even a decent run in the playoffs. And it's just, it's the land of suck continuously.
Yeah.
And it's frustrating. And, you know, hey, it's early in the NFL season. Who knows what the Redskins are capable of? But, you know, they hit the.
I know.
You were there.
Yeah, I know what they're going to be capable of. They'll be easy to get tickets about November 3rd, folks.
Yeah, but it is. But you will admit, the thing about the NFL, especially early in the season, is you get these teams that from 1 week to the next, it's night and day.
Yeah.
Like when they beat St. Louis, Rob, you know everybody's like, okay, this
That's
Kirk
it.
Cousins, it's for real.
It's for real.
And then
I haven't seen this since
1982.
It's the greatest thing I've ever seen. I'm getting my tickets to the Super Bowl.
You know, this is going to sound well, take a break. I have some theories on football. Watching the Green Bay game last night. And it's really weird. I'm not the first one that said it, but
really?
I don't know. Maybe I was goofy tired last night. We'll take a break. Come back with more fun and more thrills. Then I'll tell you about my trip to the nursing home.
Nice.
Or the assisted living facility, which is the new suite name.
Dropping off an application?
Right here. Well, you know, never too early to prepare, Rob. We'll take a break. Come back with more fun and more thrills on the Michael O'Meara Show.
Swears on backwards and inside out.
Hello, this is Matt Bloom, you know, Pony Boy. We wanted to bring some sizzle to the mailbag, so they brought me in, Mr. Excitement, to really get you guys riled up. Mm-hmm. If you want to get in on the red hot action, just send an email to Robb at MikeOmeraShow.com.
Yeah!
That's Robb with two B's.
Woo!
Or if you like mail, P.O. Box 2796, Leesburg, Virginia, 20177. I hate mail. It's too slow. I crave action.
Action.
So if you have a question or comment, send it along. And now, time for a nap.
Yeah.
Let's go, Pony!
Hey, that's nice.
Welcome back to the Mike O'Meara Show, brought to you by Nuts.com. Listen up, nut munchers.
Yes?
Why settle for small nuts at the grocery store when you can have big, beautiful nuts from Nuts.com? Simply the best. We have been chowing down on this product from Nuts.com. It is the best tasting. It is the best size. It is just convenient. It's the best nut shopping on the internet. Rob, you've got a nut story, do you not?
What is so great is they've enjoyed such success since they started their run with us. Nuts.com, I got a message from their CEO, and I'd like to play it for you if I may.
Okay, let's listen.
I used to be able to name every nut that there was.
Yes.
I say peanut, right. Hazelnut,
yeah.
Cashew nut,
yeah, right.
Macadamia nut.
Okay, we can go on and on. Thank you very much, Rob.
It's very simple. It's a convenient way to have nutritious, delicious, healthy nuts and other treats from all around the world delivered straight to your door. I love the website. Great pictures, easy to navigate, easy to search. Ordering is a breeze. Right now, new customers can get 4 free samples. This is a generous offer.
It is.
Go to nuts.com and use our code TMOS. That is a $15 value. You would be nuts not to do it. You get it? Nuts.com has been family-owned since 1929. They're always a 100% satisfaction guarantee. They have dried fruits, sweet treats, over 3,000 snacks. Carla bought some baked good products. Mm. They've got coffees, teas. Nuts, nuts, nuts.com. Big, salty, sweet. Whatever kind you like to munch on, let them take care of you and your taste buds right now. New customers, get 4 free samples. Choose from over 50 options. That's a $15 value, by the way. When you go to nuts.com and use the code TMOS. That's nuts.com and the code TMOS for 4 free samples with your order. Delicious. Nuts.com. And we thank you.
Cashew nut.
You know, I was out of it, the running as far as fantasy football last night, but I still looked in
on the
Green Bay game last night. And I have to tell you something that was just kind of surreal for me. I suddenly realized, have you ever watched a football game and let your mind kind of drift as to how truly silly that sport appears to be sometimes?
Mm-hmm. How do you mean?
I'm watching it, and Carla and I start talking about this, and then we start giggling. And just when you talk about the actual game of football, and I know this will piss a lot of people off, but it just started to make me laugh. They had this Green Bay offensive lineman that they had a close-up of, and he was walking back from to the sidelines, and he just I guess they were giving him a break, or that was the it was punting time. I don't know what it was, but anyway. He's sitting there, and he's got this giant tummy that's kind of hanging over his yellow pants.
Yes.
And suddenly I said, do you ever realize how silly they really look? How kind of silly they look in these outfits, you know? And, I mean, I think all sports uniforms are a little silly. Hockey uniforms, baseball uniforms.
But we've come to accept them without thinking about it.
We accept them, and we accept. And I started giggling watching this, and I said, I love this game. But it's silly. If an alien came down from another planet and said, okay, let me see if I've got this straight. You got these guys on a field, and they're wearing helmets because they're hitting each other in the head.
Right.
And one guy's wearing yellow pants that come up to his knee, and they're super tight, but he's wearing thigh pads and knee pads. I started giggling about it and thinking about the actual game itself, and it is a little silly. And then I said, and then I said to Carla, look at how serious they're taking it.
Yes.
And at this point, they were having the referees in their striped shirts having a little serious meeting about everything. And I said, it really doesn't change the world at all. It's our diversion. And I thought somebody that was of a more elevated the intellectual life form would come down and look at this and go, this is really kind of insane.
If you take it to the next level, it's not just the seriousness of the 22 men on the field in their festive outfits or the men in the striped shirts that are really trying their very hardest to make
it's 70,000 faithful surrounding
there's
them.
There's the 70,000 people that are watching and saying, this means something.
And I watch that, and at the same time, I see that they get a shot of a Green Bay fan who is painted green and yellow with spikes coming out of his head, and I said, and this is one of the and I went, we're an interesting species. We are truly an interesting species,
yeah.
And I just thought it was a little interesting. That's all.
I draw a parallel to this ad and some of the people at Comic-Con. You know, it's they're at a big event, and they want people to look at them.
Mm-hmm. Right. But sumo wrestling, that's the one, right? That's the
Did
one
you
where
see the
aliens
the viral
come.
Video of the sumo wrestler that was like a skinny white guy?
No.
Not skinny, but he was muscular, but apparently...
Oh, I won't play the pony tape then.
Thank you.
This guy is over in Japan, and he's killing it. And
really?
He's not, and he's breaking all the rules because he's not one of these fat guys. He's like kind of a muscular, thick, white guy that's over there, and he's beating these Japanese sumo wrestlers. But,
wow.
You know, it, sumo wrestling is basically you try to throw the guy out of the circle.
That's it.
How sumo, when I did it. When I did it back in the 1980s.
Well, actually, Mike and I met at a bar appearance where we wore the sumo suits. But that was a long time ago.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
I'm finding pictures of a white guy, right?
Yeah, he's a white guy. I forgot what the guy's name is. Let me see.
Is it Takayama Shitaro?
No. I don't think that's him.
Let me see. Hold on.
Do the people of Japan, do they hate this guy because he is laughing in the face of tradition?
I don't think they would. I think they'd be all about it.
Oh, stop it. Stop it. Don't do that to me.
What, was it an ad?
Yeah, it was an ad.
How dare they?
A Japanese ad.
How dare they with their Japanese sumo ads?
Yeah, your Japanese sumo. I got a new loincloth.
I want to see if it's
hey,
the right
guy. Do you
guy
think there's actual manufacturers like Nike and Under Armour that use...
There he is. Okay,
oh, I'm sure there are.
Right?
Yeah. There has to be.
For
well,
sumo?
Because it's YouTube.
Well, they don't wear shoes.
All it says is white muscular man. And it says Taka, like Oscar said, Taka
Shitanaro.
Takanayama. He's Czech, right? He's a Czech dude.
Is he Czech?
That's what it says here. Yeah, it says he's Czech.
Yeah, but back to your original point. If aliens came down and saw Taka or whoever in the sumo suits, and that was them, they think the society was ass backwards.
Oh,
yeah,
you know what? Guess what? It's old. It's old video.
Oh.
Taka.
New to me, Taka, Mike. It's new to me.
Takanayama Shuntaro is also known as Pavel Bohar.
Sure.
He is a former sumo wrestler from Prague, Czech Republic, and he is the first man from the Czech Republic to join the professional sport in Japan. All right, let me see. He's made his debut in the top division in September 2011. He retired on July 24th, 2014.
Oh, so God, I hope he comes back, Mike. The sport needs him.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he really re-energized the sport.
Yeah, there I was, the thing I rail against, sucked in once again by an elderly video, just like I got sucked in by a documentary that was new to me, but not new to anybody else. Have you guys seen Winnebego Man?
No.
Winnebego Man. Does it have to do with a fellow, I imagine, in a large motorhome?
I don't know about you, Winnebego Man.
There is a documentary that was made about a viral video that I don't know how many million hits it's had over the years.
The Salesman?
It's The Salesman.
Oh, I've seen
I know
that.
The
yeah,
viral video. Yeah.
Years ago.
Winnebago
years ago.
Man.
Yeah.
They did an entire documentary. I cannot possibly recommend it more highly. It is on Netflix. You have to look at this. It's called Winnebago Man. And I don't know how many hits
I'd take
this
it
guy,
back.
But what I've the gist it. Of it is that this Winnebago guy, who's been all over the internet, everybody's seen this video of the guy doing an industrial video for a Winnebago dealership and just going nuts, cussing, yelling at everybody.
Yeah.
And I guess there is this underground with the intranets where people collect this stuff, these viral videos.
Sure.
And the documentary centers on this one filmmaker hunting this guy down. He went off the radar after he ruined his career with Winnebago, and nobody knew anything about this guy. And when he finally tracked him down, it turned out that he had been a broadcaster. He was a television broadcaster, and he'd worked on the network level. And he's living on his own up in the mountains of Northern California. And they found this guy, and it turned out to be what he's touched.
Well, maybe do you think he's a little touched in the head? You've seen the movie.
Well, I'll tell you, if you want, you got to formulate your own opinion. I normally don't. I don't give homework assignments.
I think
out,
he's man, the man personally. And Mike, thank you. I thought you were talking about a different documentary, but I have seen it, and I feel like that man, like, he had so many big dreams that just didn't come through, and that in itself killed his own will to succeed.
It's
old.
It's been out a while. Its initial release was in 2000. His name is Jack Remney.
Have you ever seen a grizzled radio guy that never made it to the top 10 market?
Every time I look at him. Yeah.
every time you look into your monitor. Hi. How are you? I'm up here in Maine.
But your tactic is still working. Take Mike without a job.
Okay.
All right?
I gotcha. Yeah.
And then you've got Winnebago Man.
Okay.
By the way,
He's got T-shirts.
Show 7 will be profiling yours truly on October 6th and 7th up here. At, so
do they have the clip of your legendary Winnebago rave out?
The Winnebago meltdown. I've had one of those. This guy's name is Ben Steinbauer, who made this documentary. So you've seen it, Oscar?
Yes, yeah, I totally
is
forgot.
Is it not the sweetest thing at the end?
It is so fun.
You'd adore this.
Okay, I'll watch it tonight.
Adore this documentary. It is
a happy end. It isn't like cut to black.
Because, you know,
over.
It would seem when you talk about a guy who lost his entire career because he's screaming about the Browning element,
He just, that in itself haunted him.
Do you have T-shirts, Pony? Does he have T-shirts?
He has a T-shirt, and you can get it on Amazon.
And what does it say on it?
It says, "Can you do me a kindness?"
Oh, that's his big. That's one of his. It is really, really worth.
I'll take
a
peek.
You know, when TV is light, I sometimes go deep into documentaries, and I try to find something that's unique. And Jack Rebney is
Mike,
blind.
Most people get a chance to actually go that deep. So when you get most people have Netflix, get a chance, dig in, find it. It's a lot of fun.
Documentaries are one of the best things to watch on Netflix. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I will tell you, even though it was released in 2010, if you haven't seen it, it totally holds up. And what it does is it shows you that we are so addicted to these viral videos, and quite often you give no thought whatsoever to the humanity of the person that's in them. They're cartoon characters for us.
Sure.
And that's exactly what it was with this guy. And it was sad, but at the end it was kind of happy.
Sweet.
But it was also strange. You never really get to who the guy really is.
Right.
And, you know, obviously there's some pain there, right, Oscar?
Oh, yeah.
He's had himself a bit of a life. It was very, very strange. But if you want to check it out, it's called Winnebego Man, and it's available on Netflix. You can get it there.
See, so a lot of people go to Winnebago Man, and they think it's a superhero movie. And it turns out it has nothing to do with
By the way, 90% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Technically, Mike was a Winnebago Man for 4 days.
That's right. And I like to call it the happiest 4 days of our lives.
It's called Unraveling the Cosmos. Check it out. We'll take a break and come back with more fun and more thrills on the Mike O'Mara Show. I'll talk about the home.
Good.
You wanted control. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show, everybody. Hey, everybody. It's almost time, kids. It's the Mike O'Mara Show. Mad Fox made his
What does the fox say?
Wednesday, October 14th, right here in our nation's capital. The entire TMOS crew will be at the Mad Fox Brewing Company's Glover Park Tap Room. It's Mike, Oscar, Robb, all the rest. Pony's even come out and drink martinis at a beer.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Meeting, greeting, and having a ball. Do not miss it. What is the difference between a brew pub and a tap room? Same thing, isn't it, basically?
Yes.
A tap room actually serves and doesn't brew there.
Yeah.
That's the difference. So the tap room actually has all the Mad Fox beers, but they don't actually brew the beers at the Mad Fox Glover Park location.
See, I thought a tap room, Mike, was a rehearsal space.
Oh.
The Gregory Hines tap room.
I was there with Ann Miller.
You win. Is your brew going to be on sale? Your Chad
They've
Oscar
sold out.
Brew?
What?
They've sold out. I went there That's yesterday incredible. For dinner before Tech 411, and I was like, "Hey, can I get a maneuver?" They said, "Sold out." I said, "All right, moving on."
Man, well, maybe they'll reload and you'll
hopefully,
have some
man, hopefully.
From 6 till 9 p.m., come spend time and have a brew with your favorite podcast buddies. You can get the address and directions at madfoxbrewing.com or write this down conveniently. 2218 Wisconsin Avenue Northwest. Got it? Good. Remember, Wednesday, October 14th at 6 p.m., we'll see you at the Mad Fox Brewing Company's Glover Park Tap Room for the happiest hour you've ever experienced. Come thirsty, leave happy. That's
come do us a kindness.
Please do us a kindness.
And visit with us.
If you don't adore this documentary, I'm going to be stunned.
I can't wait to watch it tonight.
You're going
to
love it. Didn't get a chance yesterday on the show to talk about my drive down to see my mamo over the weekend. Had dinner with her this weekend, and it's unusual because I had I was trailing a big boat, and I had to deal with that. And so I left the kidling and the wifeling at home, and made my way down to just outside of Boston to the Sunny Acres. to the Morningwood.
Stop it. Now you're just going to get yourself in trouble.
New Horizons?
Yes. I went down, and the thing about it is both my sister and my mom said, well, I think she's taking you to the dining room, so bring a jacket. They've still got the little dress code. God
sure.
love them. They have the standards at this little place. Yeah. So she doesn't eat there off. I said, how often do you eat there, Mama, in the actual formal dining room? She said, twice a week. So, and what's cool is that they, you know, it is old school in the very purest sense of the word.
Okay.
But they still dress for dinner. Not super fancy, but you wear, gentlemen are encouraged to wear a jacket. So
I think that's nice.
Mm-hmm. I brought my school pants with me, and I brought my jacket, and I thought that this would be a very, very nice event. And because the day ended up being longer than I anticipated, suddenly I looked at my nav, and it was like 5:30, and I was having to bust ass to get there because, you know, they eat early down
there. Sure, 5:30, they're cleaning up.
Yeah, and so it was bittersweet to see my mom. You know, at 95, you're old. That's all there is to it. And it's something that you accept that reality. It happens. It's going to happen to all of us unless we get hit by a bus.
Mm.
And the thing about it was I realized how little one-on-one time with just talking with her and seeing how she's doing that I get when she's with my little guy running around and Carla's there or my
sure.
daughters are there. It's always kind of a dog and pony show, but now this was a chance to go down and see her. And so I made my way there, and I got there to my hotel at about 5:30. And then it was a fire drill getting over to see her.
What time were you due at the for dinner?
About, it was made clear, dear, that
yes,
it's 6:15 weekend. And so I get the call. I get one call from her. How are you doing? I said, I'm doing fine. Okay. You have a jacket? Yes, I have a jacket. I'm coming down. And then the second call was that progress report. I said, Mom, I'm getting there. I'm going to be there at 5:30. She's excited. She's very excited.
Aww.
And I think that I got the impression that she was excited because she wanted me to go with her to her dining room. That was the, so
okay.
I didn't have any leeway. That's why I was busting my butt. Then the last call, listen, if you're having trouble with traffic, Mom, I'm going to make it. We could always go to the 99 and just have a sandwich. I said, Mom, I'm going to be there. And then, so that was
actually
the last call.
Actually, what you said is, at the 99, I don't have to wear a jacket, right?
No, the thing is, I realized at that moment when I got the third call, the
right.
urgency, that
sure.
she needed me there, and I was going to make it without any trouble whatsoever. And I didn't take a bathroom break on the way down. When I got to the hotel, I had that wonderful experience of walking into the lobby of the hotel with the phone ringing, and no one at the desk.
Oh.
So you realize this only happens when there are minutes to spare, where
yes.
you literally don't have seconds to spare, and you have to get into your school clothes, and you also have to, you know, go winky tinky.
And that's, you know what else is, you know, we have spent many, many hours together through the years and on the
yes.
air and off. I always seem to think of you, when I think of you as a frustrated fella checking into a hotel.
It's
you
not one of my favorite things
you
to do.
You don't ever get any luck checking into
no.
a hotel.
And,
ever.
And I think that the process itself, if they removed the human factor out of that,
it's antiquated.
I would be very happy.
Think
I would
of
be
how
very
you check
happy.
Out of a hotel. You drop the key in the slot. That's right. what they need to introduce to the checking into a hotel.
Well,
pick
look,
up your
they've
key
done
and
it
go.
At airports now.
Yes.
You don't have to have human contact. Well, you do have to have. If you're bringing luggage on a plane, that's the whole thing with the airline industry.
Right.
You have to have human contact. But if they can remove the human being from that, so, well, you're going to kill jobs. Yes, Mike O'Mara, job killer.
That's
Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
That's
Please
you.
Please do that. So,
read the fine print on our website. That's what it says.
The phone is ringing, and the young lady, as I stand there, the young lady comes out and is very...
Hey!
Yes, it's exactly what she looked like.
No,
and,
no.
And so she comes out, and she's very nice and says, excuse me, can I just take this? I said, go ahead. And then, obviously, I could hear on the other end of the line, I could actually hear the voice,
sure.
which is the first tell that it is a member of the Blue Hair Club. And
you hear,
well, they're traveling now. This is their time to be on the... Everyone else is working, but they are on the roads now. They're eating, drinking, pooping, and they're occupying hotels. There's blue hair everywhere.
Sure.
In the restaurants and everywhere. And, well, I shouldn't be complaining about it because I'm going to see them over at the home as right. well.
Yeah.
So, but these are the more sensible blue hairs that have a home base.
I hear, on the other end, I hear... not this evening, ma'am. We are sold out. Well, I would suggest calling another hotel. There are many hotels in the area. No, we are sold out. At this point, I want to grab the phone and say, what don't you understand about sold out? Call another hotel, and why don't you use the internet like every normal human being, you old hag? Anyway, so
yeah, but what the crone wants, Mike, the crone wants this hotel to feel bad and book something for her.
Yeah, because the entitled, it's like,
exactly.
Well, you have to be sold out with me.
Don't you know who I am?
I have to get back down to Florida where it's warm and where Mike lives, and I can be like, like a locust.
Anyway, so I'm sitting there and I start to count, and it was 12 minutes. The process for checking in was 12 minutes. It's 12 minutes I didn't have. I get up to the fourth floor of the part of the hotel which is, as the crow flies, as humanly impossible to find in short time than anywhere. You can, there's not a place in this motel strip where you can park your car and access my particular room easily.
Right.
It is a, listen, thanks so much. Sorry to keep you 15 minutes waiting down here, but you got about a 6 mile walk to room 415. And when you get up there, you'll be. So at this point, I'm not even thinking about being late. I'm thinking about my bladder because I've been in the car for 3 hours and I get up to the fourth floor. The elevator opens. I walk down the hallway and there is a maintenance man coming towards me. He said, what room are you checking in?
Oh,
I said, room 415. I knew it. And that's when my heart sank.
Oh, no, what?
He was swapping out a new toilet.
Oh, my goodness.
At this point, I said, do you have a pass key? Is there any room that's not occupied? I said, I can take you down. And then with that great solution that all dicks do, I can take you down to the lobby. There's a public one. Down. I said, yeah, I know there's one. The 7 miles back down to the 12-minute wait where I can do that, but please. And mean now I'm looking, and it's 20 of 6, okay? And I am not going to disappoint an old lady. I said, he said, so if you want to go down, we can get you another room. I said, listen, I'm all set. Got it covered. Just got to duck in for a second. He said, well, I'm going down to get the toilet. I said, you go down and get that toilet. I'll be in the room, and I'll be out of there by the time you get back. Have a nice day, sir. Thank you very much. And I went up, and I peed in the sink.
Yeah!
Yes!
I peed in the sink. I'm not a big sink peer since my college days.
Mike, so you got to go. You got to go.
You know,
I peed in the sink.
Yeah.
And so,
who swaps out a new toilet?
Yeah, it's
like in the middle of the
somebody,
you know,
somebody just, did some serious damage.
Jesus. That's something you do when you remodel home or a hotel, I imagine.
Well, apparently that toilet was problematic. So his tools, I moved his tools
Mike, from the sink. They know your reputation, and they wanted to prepare.
Big pot is coming over.
Constant yakking. So I got into my clothes, flew over, got to the home, had at this point I called. I said, Mom, I'm here in the drive. I'm going to meet you outside. And she was she's on a walker now.
Okay.
And she met me outside, and it was as I said, it was bittersweet for me. She's so vibrant intellectually, and she's got her mind, and she's fun to talk to. But she's getting smaller. You know what I mean? Mom's getting smaller, yeah. And it was just it was sweet. And she says, I can't believe all the years I've been here, and I just found out this shortcut. And she takes me to a little shortcut that she has where she goes into the
Does she pull a book and then a bookshelf open?
Exactly. Opens up Shakespeare's head.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you, it was wonderful. It really was. She's introducing me to the people that work there. She's introducing me to her friends. And I love the under-the-breath little comments where... first of all, I had no shortage of 6 people greet her when we were sitting down in the dining room that said, we love her. And
aww,
when somebody gets that kind of reaction from people, you know, you'll get the handshake. Oh, very nice to meet you. But they were specifically saying that she's wonderful. My mom takes jokes out of our hometown paper, the Glastonbury Citizen, which she still gets.
I thought that was
hometown.
You.
No, that's not me.
It's Mike O'Mara, the Glastonbury Citizen.
She gets the jokes from the local paper that they still print in my little hometown, and she reads them, memorizes them, and then she tells them to all her buddies.
Are they mostly dirty jokes?
Filthy.
I
they're
thought
like Playboy
so.
Jokes. Yeah. They're penthouse jokes.
Party jokes, Mike.
Yeah, penthouse party jokes?
They're Playboy's party jokes. And she tells jokes. But she is beloved. And then I will save the best for last that happened in the dining room. But on the way back. And we
How
got
was
a
the
good,
food?
It was small. It was small portions. I had a flank steak and green beans, and you could have put it in a Dixie cup. That's
why your mom is getting smaller. Well, yeah. They're not feeding her.
It was beautiful. It was sweet, and it was just nice to be there. And I got introduced to everybody, and I stood up with everybody she introduced me to.
Good.
And they said,
good
don't
for you.
Stand up. And it was just, you know, I love her so much. She's such a sweet lady. And we're walking back. And there are, I've talked about the stages of this place. Phase one is where you have your apartment and you have a car and you can drive into town. Phase two is if you have a nurse that can come visit you, you stay in your apartment.
Right.
They do that. And phase three is the full-fledged nursing facility where when she, my mom broke her back a while back. You
remember
that.
Yeah.
And she stayed in this facility there. And this is the first thing that kind of indicated to me that, you know, time marches on, where she kind of spoke about it. She said, I told him to reserve my room there. So she's got that in her mind a little bit because she's a realist and she's very aware of it. And they
but do you
adore
know, but
her.
But do you know how great
here.
That is?
Yeah,
that
it's
is,
great. It's
a
great.
Good person.
These facilities, they're not cheap, but I will tell you that they transition people, elderly people, in a way that is, I think, I can't think of any more humane way of doing
God
it.
God willing, and Mike, people feel the same way about us when we get there, right?
That's right.
Yeah, absolutely.
True enough.
And yeah. I love old people that aren't down in Florida, you know, standing in line at a restaurant.
Or driving.
But anyway, or driving or anything. Look, my mom, you know what? My mom has never, ever been in that category of the entitled masses.
Right.
And, you know, when you're sitting in a restaurant and you hear a 75-year-old guy bitching out a waitress, it wears on you, and you see a lot of that in South Florida. You do.
Right.
That's the reality of it, and I can't stand it. But she introduced me to the nurses, and they remembered her, and she's just she's kind of a Pollyanna where I don't know what happened to me. But as I told her later on that night, I told her, I don't want to get emotional, but I told her that she is my role model.
Aww.
Because she is. She is. Because although I don't achieve it, and I rarely achieve it, I do think that as I age, I'm going to try to be more like she is to people than the examples that I see on the other side. Which, and I think men tend to be a little more curmudgeon-y than women do.
Yeah.
You get this meh, these meh, and I see it all the time. And then I see her with everybody giving her bear hugs, and it's fantastic. And you would think, well, she's the perfect woman. Well, we had a little chink in the armor.
Oh,
let me just
dear.
Say, there was just one issue.
What happened?
She had an expression on her face where we are sitting there. It's the end of dinner.
Right.
And a lady comes by, and she's got one of those electronic wheelchairs.
Sure.
And she's saying hi to everybody, and I'm not paying attention. And she finds
the wheelchair lady
hello.
Is?
And she says hi to the name of the lady. And this lady goes by. She says, hello, hi, how are you? Oh, hello, nice to see you. And as she passes, my mom looks at me and goes,
oh, wow. Oh,
what
seething.
The hell? My God, you just turned into Damien. What happened there? Yeah. And she's got her lips get thin, and she's just like, you know, she balls up her fists. I'm like, what the hell happened? She ran into me last week.
And checked goes, her in the hall?
She runs into everybody. And apparently this lady that just got her electronic wheelchair is slamming into people and not apologizing.
Not apologizing.
Not apologizing. And so there was the perfect environment of the home and everything. That's the one problem she has. She doesn't like that at all. And then there was a table of maybe, I want to say 8 or 9 old ladies in a circular table. And I said, oh, they are so sweet. I said, Mom, this is such a peaceful place. And they look like they're having such a wonderful time. And she said, well, yes, they're having a fine time. But most of them don't remember their names.
So.
That was funny.
Oh, that's great.
And then we had a little drinky poon. She got her plastic bottle of Smirnoff vodka, and I had a really nice bottle of wine that my sister dropped off. Thanks, Kathy. And it was on to other things that I saw the next morning, too.
That's
brought
great.
Brought her a pumpkin with a flower plant in it. And,
super sweet.
Brought her a candle as well, but they don't let them have candles.
Well, certainly not the ladies at that table.
Yeah, no, not on the rascal.
No candles for them.
So just like in a dorm room.
That's right. Yeah.
Thanks a lot. But, Mom, I love you, and she's still hanging in there, guys. And
nice.
She is my role model. So we'll take a break. Come back with news you may not need. This is the Michael Mayer Show. Damn wheelchair.
Hi, this is the Internet's Steve Mermelstein. Perhaps you know me from The Americast, where Marcus Serta serves as my sidekick. But I'm here to tell you about another podcast, Cake and Cookies. Cake and Cookies has Robb Spiewak and Katie Von Herman, and I never miss an episode. It's an important part of my well-balanced podcast listening diet. Besides, I love Katie, and Robb loves me. It's a strange love triangle, but you can truly feel the magic in the air. Cake and Cookies. Subscribe on iTunes or listen on the TMOS app. Mermelstein out.
Cake and Cookies. Robb and Katie.
I would like to require Steve Mermelstein to do the Mad Fox appearance spot for us. If we could get a request.
I will contact him today.
Yes. I believe that is essential. Welcome back to the Mike O'Mara Show. I want to talk about ZipRecruiter.com. Business owners, are you hiring but not sure where to find the best candidates? This is an amazing website. One thing is for sure, your company is only as good as the people you hire. That's why we love ZipRecruiter.com. If you're running a company and you're trying to hire and you want one-stop shopping that'll get you the best candidates, ZipRecruiter.com is the place you want to go. You can post to over 100 job sites with a single click, and you will be instantly matched to the best candidates. 6 million resumes.
Wow.
Think of that. 6 million people out there that want to go work for you. Just one post, and within 24 hours, you can sit back and watch your candidates appear in ZipRecruiter's easy-to-use interface. We love ZipRecruiter. You will love ZipRecruiter. They've been used by over 400,000 businesses. Shouldn't you give it a try? We have a lot of listeners in the Mike O'Mara Show audience that run their own businesses.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the bottom line is people are always looking for qualified candidates. ZipRecruiter.com is the streamlined way to do it and to do it efficiently and get the best people. Try ZipRecruiter today. It's free. Go to ZipRecruiter.com/TMOS and get started. That's ZipRecruiter.com/TMOS. Don't wait. Try it for free. It's for free, and you can do it right now at ZipRecruiter.com/TMOS. Thank you.
Boo. News.
There
news.
How's that for an Boo. Edit pickup?
What edit?
Motherfucker.
Hey!
There's another
it's okay,
one.
It's okay. Life is good. Man.
Life is great.
It took him 22 years to do it, but Burt Reynolds has finally paid off his divorce settlement to Lonnie Anderson.
Hey! Yes, that's great news in Jupiter.
Burt and Lonnie had one of the ugliest showbiz divorces in history when they split in 93. Allegations of infidelity, physical abuse, and even drug use. That's back in the news. It seems like that was 100 years ago where we were talking about Burt Reynolds every day. He ended up agreeing to pay her almost $250,000. It's not bad.
Not bad at all.
For the money that Burt had. He paid all but $97,000 of it, then declared bankruptcy. There's been talk over the years that he ended up in financial ruin, and he recently sold his house and a ton of movie memorabilia, but he always denied he was broke. Lonnie sued him last year,
Jesus,
for the rest of her money, and she won. Burt had to pay her $97,000 plus interest, which came to $154,520. So
I do remember when
$1,520.
He did the auction, and it was an online auction, and they had stuff from every aspect of his career, like going back to
Smoking the Bandit.
Well, I mean, like TV westerns. They had pistols and belt buckles.
Like old stuff.
Well, I'm talking about. I'm just talking history here. So I mean, he sold everything. So I wonder how he's doing money wise because he still works occasionally as an actor.
Yeah, he does. It's kind of sad. I think there's a guy that, you know, like so many of these Hollywood legends, they live so astronomically high on the hog that they get into a
beyond their means
situation after their careers are
It's
over.
The Elvis thing. They think the money's always going to roll in like it's rolling in right now.
And Lonnie was from, I guess her fame came from KRP.
KRP in Cincinnati. And I don't know what she's done since, but probably remarried. I don't know. I'd love to find out. I'll do some research on that.
I bet she looks good.
Dickler. George Zimmerman. Reportedly, I cannot believe this guy. I wonder at some point, is there a death wish here? He reportedly retweeted a photo of Trayvon Martin's corpse the other day, which somehow isn't shocking since it's coming from him. He's done a lot of crap like this. It had the caption, quote, "Z-Man is a one-man army." Twitter has since deleted it. I don't
see what it's going for,
but this guy, God. As if that's not depraved enough, he went on a Twitter rant yesterday, freaking out about people freaking out on him, while proudly displaying his avatar, which is a Confederate flag, of course. There are some of the things he said, quote, "As much as I love owning all you trolls, I have to work on my tan. Tell karma she's worthless. God protects me." He's off the rails.
Screws.
I think that, I think he's insane. I think he's going to end up dead. I really do. I think that it just seems to me that he keeps doing this.
All roads lead to that. Yeah.
But, I don't think the guy's worth it, to be honest with you. Justin Bieber is having female trouble that has nothing to do with Selena Gomez for a change. A Playboy bunny named Sarah Harris claims that good old Justin groped her breast at a party back in August, and she slapped him in the face. And it happened right after he refused to take a selfie with someone, and she defended him. She says he thanked her, gave her a hug and a kiss, then gave her the bad touch. She says, quote, "It was my instant reaction just to backhand him across the face." Meanwhile, an Australian model claims her drink was drugged at a Melbourne recording studio on Sunday night while she was hanging out with Justin and his posse. She says she poured herself a drink, then set it down and started talking to another woman. Later on, after going back to her drink, she started feeling woozy.
Hey, you feel a little woozy, miss?
And her vision blurred. She started to cry. Justin actually sat with her to calm her down. Well, then why is this a story? Police were called, but she never filed a report. The owner of the studio says footage from the night shows that nobody touched her drink.
Man.
The owner of the studio. Nobody touched a drink.
Hey, listen.
No problem.
Nobody touched a drink making the Melbourne, Australia studio.
Mike, I guarantee you, even if it's in Australia, the first voice was right for the owner of the studio.
Yeah, nobody touched a drink.
You sit down, little lady.
It's fine.
Bieber still being a dick.
Bad guy.
All right, speaking of people, has-beens, nothing but has-beens. Sean Astin said there's absolutely no doubt that this is for Oscar, that a Goonies sequel will happen.
Yes.
Unfortunately, it sounds like he's just blowing smoke and really has no inside info. He adds, quote, "The precise makeup of it," Rudy says, "I have no idea whether I..." And by that, Sean Astin is Rudy.
Yes, of course.
A Rudy fan like I am. "The precise makeup of it, I have no idea whether I will be in it. No idea. Whether they would even want the original cast in it. No idea. But it doesn't matter. It's bigger. It's actually bigger than everybody. It's bigger than even Steven Spielberg, who created it. It's bigger than director Richard Donner, who breathed such strong life into it." We're talking about Goonies, right?
Goonies, yes. Not probably bigger than Steven Spielberg.
Mm. It's now a part of American cultural lore, he says.
I don't know.
And the studio has a lot to gain from promoting it, so you can take it to the bank that people will get to enjoy it more. I don't know why he's talking to him. Sounds like he's auditioning.
You know what? They'll never be able to do it, Mike, because they're missing one key ingredient. The ingredient of Ramsey. Ann Ramsey is dead, and you can't make the movie without
CGI.
Ann Ramsey. No.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
Yeah, and make her pretty, too.
Well, CGI?
Here it is. He adds that he and Corey Feldman once came up with an idea for a sequel and pitched it, but they were, quote, respectfully dismissed.
Oh.
There you have
Feldman.
It.
Feldman. Mouth.
A guy named James Gray from Aloha, Scotland, was on a flight to Amsterdam this weekend on KLM Airlines. Nice airline.
Yes.
And he had to go to the bathroom, but somehow he got confused. Oh, I think I know why.
Oh, dear.
And he thought the airplane door was the bathroom door.
Drinky, drinky.
Well, who hasn't?
Not sure,
but
he's a Scottish guy who was going on vacation, so I think he was drunk. Anyway, as soon as he touched the door handle, the staff on the airplane flipped out, you think?
Wow.
Even though it would have been impossible for him to open it because of the pressure, he was arrested when the plane landed, thrown in jail, and just fined $675, and had to take a flight back to Scotland on a different airline. So long, you laddie! You can't handle your whiskey.
There you go.
And now a little something-something. If you drink coffee in the morning because you can't even imagine trying to focus on what your coworkers are saying without it, don't worry. They all feel the same about you. A new survey found 44% of people can't have a conversation in the morning until they've had their coffee. Anybody in this room that's a coffee person that has to have
I have coffee occasionally, but no, I mean, I'm not that beholden
to it. You're not addicted
to it.
No. Also, they can't make their commute without it. I used to be like that back in the early days of the morning.
Really?
Show.
Yeah.
I could not make my commute
How many
my
cups
coffee.
Again?
I would have a 16-ounce cup going over the Bay Bridge, pick up two 16-ounce cups at the 7-Eleven on the other side of the Bay Bridge, drink one on my way into Washington, and one before the show started.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
How you doing? I'm Morning Zoo. How you doing, everybody? Well, everybody else in those days was doing coke. But 40% say they can't focus on emails until they have coffee, and 38% can't even have breakfast without it. The survey also found that 57% of us need at least two cups of coffee through the day to be productive and alert at our work. Now, I don't drink coffee, but I match those stats exactly. You just have to have a substitute, vodka for coffee.
I see.
It matches absolutely. I'm under the influence of that right now.
It matches up.
Yes, and my conversations are better. But anyway, we'll take a break, come back with the Audio Vault and Robb Spiewak right here on the Mike O'Mara Show.
Waiting for you in the hotel.
It's Tony and Gary.
Hey there, boys and girls. I'm Tony Perkins.
I'm Robb Ford's uncle.
On this week's episode of the show, it's a good thing Robb Ford's uncle is here because Robb misbehaves.
Oh, boy. Does he?
We have to put him in his place. Also, yeah. The great comedian Godfrey live in the studio right here with us.
He's fantastic.
Check it out, TonyPerkinsShow.com. Subscribe on iTunes and download the new Tony Perkins Show app.
The Tony Perkins Show.
Gotta check that one out. Gotta see how Rofo's misbehaving.
They had to bleep him.
What do you say? Settle down?
That's Robb. Read his own press, Rofo.
Did he derail?
Was he copping a little
tude
with them?
He made a pretty intense joke that made me say... He didn't really just say that, did he? Worth listening to. Worth listening
to. Boy.
That's what's going to get him fired, huh?
Yeah. Welcome back to the show. Summer is gone, and it's time to get ready for the season of autumn. You see, some people call it autumn. I call it fall. But not because of falling leaves. I call it fall because when I see great prices at Amazon, I fall down. Amazon has everything you need for the upcoming months.
Hey!
School supplies, costumes, and candy for Halloween, rakes, leaf blowers. And if you're smart and think ahead, it's never too early for snow shovels, ice melter, and dazzling Christmas lights. Get the snow shovels early this year.
Have them on hand.
Take a little gamble.
Yes.
Get your snow shovels from Amazon.
Buy a snow blower.
Right. Shop at home, beat the crowds, and save some moolah. Plus, always the right time of year to buy a beautiful new grandfather clock.
Yes.
At affordable prices. Besides, anytime you purchase something through our Amazon link, we get a tiny percentage. It's an engine for the show. It's a driver for the show. So if you're shopping Amazon anyway, please shop in a way that helps us out. It doesn't cost you any extra, and it's the best way to support our show. Next time you need to buy anything, go to MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon or click the Amazon button on our website or use the TMOS app and click on the shopping cart and shop like you normally would. It's that simple. Thanks, and may God bless you. Let's open up the Audio Vault for Tuesday, September 29, 2015. Robb Spiewak.
I know we really don't know celebrities, but many celebrities have reputations that sort of precede them, and one of them is that Matt Damon seems to be a pretty good guy.
Yes.
And a report came out on the internet that he said gay actors would be better served if they stayed in the closet. And
he's outspoken and he gets himself in trouble a lot. I think his heart's in the right
place,
but he gets in trouble.
Turns out he was misquoted, but it's really hard to undo something that goes out on the internet.
Well, see, now that's because that's what I'm hearing about it too, that he said that.
No, so he actually was on Ellen yesterday and explained what happened. And I thought it was cool, A, that he did it, and also B, that Ellen gave him the platform to do it, because there aren't many platforms that are big enough to take this on. Ellen is a pretty good way to do it, though, and I liked this moment.
Yeah, it was just in an interview with The Guardian that I literally just found out, too. But I was just trying to say actors are more effective when they're a mystery, right? somebody picked it up and said, I said gay actors should get back in the closet. It's painful when things get said that you don't believe, because
right.
nobody in the blogosphere, there's no real penalty for just taking the ball and running with it. You know what I mean? You're just trying to get people to click onto your
sure.
thing. So,
and it gets a lot of attention because someone mentioned it to me this morning, and I know you, and I know you're not that guy,
right.
and so I just wanted you to be able to.
Well, thank you for
yeah.
that. Yeah.
And it shocks me that you and Ben are not gay, but I think.
well,
she's a good egg.
She is, and I thought that
I like
was
her.
A
I
really
like her. Mm-hmm. She did him a solid there, and that's fantastic.
I like both those people on that clip, and I thought that
I
was
do,
a good way
you know,
to
Matt
handle
Damon
it.
On a talk show on Letterman, he was the best. I used to love him.
Oh, he's and, excellent.
You know, he was a great interview on the old Don and Mike show, and I've always liked him. And I love his movies, and I hope The Martian is a killer. I
yeah.
hope that just kills. I'm really looking forward
something
to it.
Something to go see, Mike. You can see it this weekend.
Yeah, are you going to go see it this weekend?
No, I'll see it this weekend. You should see it this weekend as well. Don't see Black Mass, you'll commit suicide. It's really a downer.
Really?
The acting's
really?
Phenomenal. So it's just too dark.
Let me tell you what I read about it.
You Black Mass, should not watch
and also
it.
You hate Johnny Depp.
I don't like Johnny Depp.
You'll come out of it mad and depressed.
Okay, you got it. You sold me. Yeah. That's it. I'm not going to do it.
Or if you like Matt Damon, Rent, We Bought a Zoo.
That's oh, no.
also great. Oh, my God. Yesterday, was anybody affected? Facebook was down yesterday.
In the Fox News, Facebook's down. Yeah, that's supposed to be Facebook there. It's Facebook's not working. So Shut if you're all narcissistic mm-hmm. and want to share every bit of your life with the rest of the world, they don't care anyway. And a few minutes off Facebook will not kill you. That said, Facebook is down. Please panic and tweet about it. Maybe you could start an Instagram story, because those things are working, thankfully. But Facebook is not working. Not right now. Facebook not working. Be very afraid.
I love Shep.
Uh-huh. Shep is the best. That's a Shep story right there. I like him.
Also, yesterday evening, you got to hear something that we've never heard before.
September 28th, 2015. From Comedy Central's World News headquarters in New York, this is The Daily Show with Trevor Noah.
So now Trevor Noah is hosting The Daily Show, Mike.
Tomorrow we'll get a chance to talk about this. I want to give him a second night. I want to give him a second
it's
night.
It's tough.
I
and you
say.
Know what? He probably needs a couple weeks, I would guess.
He probably needs a couple of weeks. But when you know, right away, when you're booking Kevin Hart as your first guest, it tells me all I need to know. I hate to say that, but it tells me where they're going. There are so many radio and television executives that are so utterly full of shit.
Mm-hmm.
I have to say this. It is stunning to me. You know, when I talked about my buddy up here at Ness and Don Orsillo, he's not my buddy, but I call him a buddy because everybody loves the guy.
Right.
And reading the articles about how they had a tribute to him and got a standing ovation in Fenway Park, and then the people at New England Sports Network didn't show it. You know, it's just despicable. There's just so much. I'm stunned that people that are inside the business don't have the perspective on being outside. I wish the guy, it's an unenviable job to take.
Of course.
It's a cherry gig to get also. And right now, I'm seeing affability and lots of smiling, and the bite is gone.
I
don't see that
happening. They need to make the show the star. And maybe
yes.
if they can
exactly.
do that. I mean, because really, you know, the show in itself survived when Jon Stewart went and he directed the movie, his passion project, right?
Right, right.
And then you had John Oliver step in, and he killed. He absolutely killed.
John Oliver, by the way, has taken the mantle.
Yes.
And done a great job with it.
So,
and they would have been well served. But, you know, John Oliver got his gig at HBO. So
yeah.
He's got
yeah.
his own
so
thing.
He's got his gig. But So he's they have to make gig. The show the star, because if Trevor Noah can either, you know, find his footing, or they give him enough runway to find his voice, they still need to focus on the show being the star.
Yep.
Well, the show can be the star. They kept the basic format of it,
yeah.
and it's still that edgy, great video clips and all that, but they have taken out the curmudgeon-y, edgy little element by putting a pretty man in who smiles and is nervously smiling and so amused with being on the television. I don't know what crack-smoking executive decided, well, they say Jon Stewart did it. Maybe that was Jon Stewart's little bomb that he threw his former employers.
I don't know. He doesn't seem like that kind of guy. And maybe
he
sees something.
I'm give the guy a chance, but it's still not. Look, The Daily Show is on Comedy Central. You have to make the effort to go in and get it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's not something. They've got to be real. Look, it's the end of an era. Jon Stewart is gone, and I think John Oliver, if you like the John Stewart stuff, you'll like the John Oliver stuff as well. He's got the great attitude. And I think you have to have that anger, that legitimate political anger that is the only way people from the left are going to see anything in media that agrees with what they want. And Trevor Noah, is he going to do it? Siri, it's not going to work the BD.
Yeah. And we close with this. What would be greater than a BBC reporter reporting on sexual harassment than actually being sexually harassed during the report?
An online study showed a shocking 95% of people said they had been harassed, either jeered at or had obscenities shouted at them in the street. And a large proportion said they'd also been groped or grabbed inappropriately in public. Yeah, like that.
Wow.
Does the guy driving by, I think he was complimenting her on her figure. I could be wrong. That is your magic audio vault. Have a great Tuesday, everybody.
Wow.
Sorry about that, Trevor Noah. So listen, give Trevor Noah another chance, will you please? He's from South Africa.
That's it. Another Mike O'Mara Show's come and gone. Be sure and join us again for more fun and more thrills at MikeO'MaraShow.com. If you want to correspond with the Mike O'Mara Show with a letter or package, send it to TMOS, Box 2796, Leesburg, Virginia, 20177.
Important message. If you have a birthday request and you want a letter or message into the message... Let me start again.
Yes.
To get your message or birthday request to the Wednesday mailbag, email Rob. Thank you.
Thank you.
The Mike O'Mara Show relies on your word of mouth. Tell a friend about us. For Rob Spiewak and Oscar Santana,
this is Mickey Mitty saying, see you next time, everybody.
So long.
Ciao, ciao.
Hey, not so fast, Mr. Big Shot. I got to tell you that MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon is the best way to shop for anything and everything. So shop Amazon and use our website. Always open at MikeO'MaraShow.com/Amazon. Now go in peace.
Mike O'Mara, Radio Entertainment.